too negative on real estate because of retail. This morning, Federal Realty, the best-run shopping center real estate investment trust, reported a really excellent quarter. Stock has been eviscerated in 2017. It's down 10% year-to-date, thanks to the ascendance of e-commerce and fears that the supermarket space is in trouble, thanks to so much newfound competition. In fact, Federal Realty stock hit a fresh 52-week low on Tuesday. But this morning, the company delivered a gigantic beat. Federal Realty reported funds from operations per share of $1.50. Wall Street was looking for $1.47. Its revenue came in higher than expected, up 8.3% year-over-year, and management raised their full-year earnings guidance. In response, the stock rocketed up $6.40, or over 5% today. And look, if Federal Realty can actually go higher again, its 3.1% dividend yield starts to look pretty attractive. So could this REIT stock really be turning itself around, given that the company itself is doing so well? Let's take a closer look with Don Wood, the president and CEO of Federal Realty, learn more about the quarter and where the company's headed. Mr. Wood, welcome back to Mad Money. Good to see you, Don.
Have a seat.
I gave the dichotomy. I should have done a trichotomy. I think there's three things going on. I want you to see if I'm making some sense here. What people think of retail, okay, what people think of real estate, and what Wall Street thinks of real estate investment trusts. And we've got it wrong, don't we?
Well, I don't know if we've got it wrong, but the world's changing, man, and it's changing pretty quickly out there. You know, when you think about public REITs, really it was the early 90s coming out of the SNL crisis where the industry grew up a little bit.
Right.
And you know what Wall Street said? Just retail, just residential, just office. If we want the other, we'll buy the other. And that's cool. That's not a bad thing.
Right.
But boy, oh boy, it makes it hard to be a real estate person and put you in a narrow lane. That over decades, maybe that lane should be wider and maybe it should be broader.
And the idea is that you want, and I'll quote you here, those who have positioned themselves, the successful people, those who position themselves to this point for their assets to be the real estate of choice for the widest possible selection of tenants. You're not rejecting people because they want to live near retail.
No, not at all. I mean, look, at the end of the day, people want experience. People don't need to shop. They have to want to shop.
Right.
So you want to put effectively as many of the uses together, and that doesn't have to be mixed use. It can be in the right neighborhoods that have that happen. But we are not the retailer. We're the real estate. Right. And you got to be able to be in flexible enough, great locations to be able to go up, to be able to go out, to be able to create 2025 environments, not 1995 environments.
Look, we could have been talking at one point about how Sears was in. By the way, don't worry about that. That's not true. But that's what we were worried. I look at these lists. The new floor plan, fabulous small Target. BroadSoft, which is a cloud company, and Amazon are the customers that you talked about this quarter.
Well, that's right. But listen, if you could see the real estate in the places that those companies and others like that and others are choosing, it makes sense to me. It's really not rocket science what we're doing here. They're choosing places where the environment for their employees, for their customers, for their shoppers have the amenities that are necessary in 2018, 20, and 25.
And we could, look, I want people to understand this because everybody knows how I like you, Don, and I've written about you and talked about
I like
but
you too,
if
Jim.
The condominium sales were half instead of filled, the conversation would be different. It would be like, look, the reason why Wall Street separates the two is because condominiums don't work next to real estate. Rentals don't work next to real estate. But your demonstration is empirical evidence that it does.
Well, listen, first of all, let's be clear.
Okay.
When we talk about condominiums, we are talking about for sale real estate.
Right.
We don't do a lot of for sale. We do a lot of for rent and the apartments in there. But when you're creating a community, there needs to be some for sale product too.
Right.
So we do a small amount, and so far from what we can tell, and certainly up in Boston, we've hit a home run.
Now, there are people who will say, well, wait a second, he always is very transparent about the clients. Well, the stock of Bed Bath & Beyond is near a 52-week low. AMC Entertainment, Ascena, these are all near the 52-week lows. What Don doesn't realize is the companies he may think as good top 10 tenants, the stock market's saying aren't good. If something happened to any one of those, I'm seeing new rent rolls that are better than what is existing.
First of all, diversification is certainly in your business,
right,
certainly in our business, critical. So when you do look at the income streams from federal, you absolutely see no one tenant that makes up more than 3% of the earnings base, right? We've got office, we've got retail, we've got resi, we've got different types of lifestyle and
kind of. Right, because I could have said Splunk, I could have said LA Fitness, I could have cherry picked good.
The idea is that no one tenant can throw us off our game. It needs to be a collusion of a whole lot. And so far, we haven't seen that.
So now, last question. Is this the inflection quarter where people realize this? Because it's got nice yield and it's got great growth.
Look, man, I don't know.
Maybe up to
from my perspective, I will tell you, Jim, if I'm a real estate guy, take a look at the difference between private values and public values. And the bottom line is, if you were to liquidate this company asset by asset, you'd do a heck of a lot better than what it's trading for, even after today. So that says something to me.
That really does, doesn't it?
It says something to me. It's real estate, not retail, and it's been a big, broad brush that has kind of, you know, taken us all out.
You've explained a lot to people over the years. This was the best I've ever heard you explain what's changing.
Time is passing.
It's what
I guess
you
that's
do.
A good thing.
It's what you do. That's Don Wood, President and CEO of Federal Realty Investment Trust. It's long been my favorite REIT. You know that. And now you see why. Stay with Cramer. Booyah! Jim Cramer here from Mad Money. Thanks for watching CNBC on YouTube. Click here to subscribe and get the jump on my exclusives with CEOs, plus market news, investing advice, and a whole lot more.